Welcome to this week's video blog. Excuse me if my voice starts to get a little wonky. I'm sort of getting over a cold. It was worse yesterday, but so getting better. So this is my wrap up for the my book wrap up for the month of March. Yeah, we're April, beginning of April now. So I read two books in the month of March. But there were both two books that I loved, so I consider that a good reading month. The first one was Changed by You by Kristen Mayer, and it is the story of Cain and Teal. It's a book three, I think it is, in a series. So I haven't read the other books, but I believe they're all standalones. But there, I guess there are like spoilers for the first two in the sense that like you, well, it's a romance, so you assume the couples get together, but you get to see the couples in book three as well. So I really enjoyed Changed by You, loved it so much. Cain is a part of this wonderful family, and he's sort of the last holdout, kind of like he's very like stoic and cold and reserved, and he has his reasons, you know, because like he loved before and he got hurt, and he sort of closed himself off from feeling feelings, and in walks Teal, who is renting the cabin of a friend of his for the winter, and he goes out. So he has to sort of go up there and check things out, and he, you know, decides that he's I think for one reason or another, she sort of commandeers his truck and is like, oh, I'm not staying here. I'm going with you. So just their relationship is really, really cute and sweet in that Teal is a very sort of sassy, perky kind of girl, and she's like very, very fun, and I fell in love with her from like the first moment. She's horrified by the fact that Cain is a hunter. And like a trophy hunter, and he keeps his animals, trophies of his animals, like on the walls, and she's horrified by this. Some people might, you know, if you don't like the like, what's it called, like the pixie heroine, where she's all like bubbly and like happy and that kind of thing. Some people don't like heroines like that. I love heroines like that. So I loved their story, and there was a small little suspense plot, subplot going in that there was a guy who was killing all these women, and Cain starts to realize that there's some connection that he has to this killer, because the killer starts wants to target Teal as well, and of course that's when he realizes that, you know, like he's in love with her and he wants to protect her, and you know, he, but of course he, you know, still fights it because he's Mr. Grumpy Pants according to her, and that's just it was such a fun book. So I won't like spoil that suspense plot point for you, but I just felt like that's the one that I would have given this book. It's just like I understand what the point was of the little suspense subplot, but it got wrapped up so quickly and so easily, almost like it almost felt superficial. But that didn't take away from my enjoyment of the book. I still loved it. Teal is a figure skater, and she was a professional figure skater, and I think she won some level of medal in the Olympics, and then like she's sort of like reevaluating her life and deciding if she wants to like continue on with that or not, and she decides she wants to retire, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful story. I loved it so much. Oh, and there's this little subplot also as well with this little boy Judson that is heartbreaking. Like, just trigger warning for like, or tissue warning, I guess trigger warning as well. His little subplot with Kane and Teal is just heartbreaking. Just, oh my God, I was, because I listened to it in audiobook, and I was waiting for the streetcar on my way to work, and I was trying so hard not to cry. It was just heartbreaking, but it's such a beautiful, beautiful story, and I completely recommend it. Changed by You by Kristen Mayer. My second book was another C.D. Rice, who I absolutely adored her Marriage Games duology. The Marriage Games was the first book, and then Separation Games was the second book. I also loved her Prince Charming, and this time I read Bombshell, which is a story of Kara and Brad, and Kara is a nanny, and the agency that she works for places nannies with celebrity families, who so that the actors and stuff can work and stuff, and they have the nannies who take care of the kids. Her best friend got into some hot water because she had an affair with a celebrity dad. So Kara finds herself placed with this actor, Brad, who all of a sudden has a daughter that he never knew about, Nicole, who and he has no idea how to deal with her, and so Kara sort of helps him with that, all the while they're falling in love with each other. And I loved their story. It was just wonderful. And I love little Nicole, who some readers don't like books with children or what they call plot moppets. But I love Nicole. I love books with children. I love reading them. I love writing them. So yeah, that's that. I would totally, totally recommend Bombshell by C.D. Rice. I am almost finished Seduced in the Dark, Seduced by the Dark by C.J. Roberts. I'm almost finished it, and oh my God, like the beginning for me dragged a bit, but oh my God, once you get past like the halfway point, it just stuff gets revealed that like, oh my God, my poor Caleb. Yeah, so the first book in that one is Captive in the Dark, and I'm on book two, almost finished, which is Seduce in the Dark by C.J. Roberts. If you have not picked up this series, if you like dark romance, like really dark, not for the faint of heart kind of thing, then definitely pick that up. And that's going to be it for this week's video blog. Hopefully I will be finished that one. I should be finished that one by the time I do my April wrap up. So follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/authoreJamie. Like my Facebook page at facebook.com/authoreJamie, and I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!